Hi, Erwan from MotionVFX, and welcome to this new DaVinci Resolve tutorial. In this video, we will learn how to extract all the shots from one unique video file. In my media pool, I've got only one clip, and it is a complete movie with various shots and transitions. Sometimes you may receive this kind of file and your client may ask you to modify the edit, to color grade or add visual effects. To do so, you will need to cut all the various shots. It could be a tedious work, but don't worry, DaVinci Resolve provides tools to help you with this kind of situation. The first technique is to use a scene cut detection tool available directly inside the media storage. To get access to it, just do a right click on your clip and select scene cut detection. A new interface will appear over the media page. First thing to do is to click on the Auto Scene Detect button. Automatically, DaVinci Resolve will analyze the movie to find all the cuts inside. Depending on the length of your movie, it may take some time. When the analysis is complete, we can see some green and gray vertical spikes in the lower part of the interface. These spikes represent the cuts inside the movie. Let's move the playhead on this spike. On the top part, we can see three viewers. The one on the left displays the last frame on the outgoing clip. The viewer in the middle represents the first frame of the incoming clip. And the third viewer on the right represents the second frame of the incoming clip. So the picture should be very similar to the viewer in the middle. So to validate a good cut, the viewer on the left should have a different image compared to the other two. In this case, it is perfect. To navigate between cuts, you can use two shortcuts, N for next cut, and P for the previous cut. On the right part, you can see the cut list with the frame numbers and the time code, which represent the timing of the cuts. So you can click directly on the value to go to one cut. As I've mentioned before, there are green and gray spikes, but also each spike has a different height. The height of the spike represents the confidence index. And to choose the level of confidence, you can adjust the position of the horizontal pink confidence bar. Each spike below the confidence bar will be gray and won't be added to the cut list. If I decrease the position of the confidence bar, more cuts will be added to the cut list. The cut detection is based on the changes of the pixel and the luminance values. So with straight cuts, it is simple for DaVinci Resolve to handle, but if there is some transitions, like dissolve for example, DaVinci Resolve may have some difficulties to find the right frame for the cut. So we'll have to help DaVinci Resolve to add the cut at the right place. For example, at the beginning, we can see many spikes on few frames, which means there is an issue with the cut. By using the left and right arrow key, I can move frame by frame, and with the three viewers, I can see exactly where is the cut. Like here, the last frame is black, and the next one, we can see some details of the garden. I will click on Add to create a new cut. Then, I can move to the next frame and click on Delete to remove the bad cuts. I can remove only the green spikes, so if I want to clean all the spikes, you just have to decrease the confidence bar and delete the spikes. So I can use the same technique to clean the other spikes. Or to be faster, you can also create a selection area with an in and out point. Then click on the Prune button to keep only one spike, the one with the highest confidence index. If you need to close the interface for any reason, don't worry, when you call it back, your analyze and changes will be back. But if you close DaVinci Resolve, you will lose everything. To save your analysis and your changes, click on the three dots on the top right of the interface. You will get access to many features, like to save or load the scene cut project. It will save a SC file. You can also use an EDL file coming from other editing software to have an accurate cut for all the clips. Very useful. Once all the cuts are okay, you can click on the Add Cut to Media Pool button on the lower right part of the interface. It will automatically create all the clips inside the media pool. In the Edit page, you can select all the clips and add them inside the timeline. The main issue with this technique is when you want to add some transitions. As each element are individual clip, you don't have any extra content to create transition. On the good side, you can grade all the clip in the color page or add titles and effects in the fusion page. With DaVinci Resolve 17, and only with the paying studio version, there is a second way to automatically cut your movie. This time, you can add your movie inside the timeline in the edit page. In the timeline menu, you will find Detect Scene Cuts. Click on it and DaVinci Resolve will use a new neural engine to analyze your movie and split all the various clips. The neural engine is good for the straight cut, but with transitions, we can see that it won't split the clips. It's not a big issue as we can choose the right frame and split manually the clip. You will find the feature in the timeline menu, Split Clip, with the shortcuts Command plus Backslash. So I will split a couple of transitions. In case you've made a mistake, you will be able to join two clips. Same as before, go to the timeline menu and select Join Clip. Be careful, the Join feature will use the position of the playhead to join the clips. So don't select the cut, but place the playhead after the cut you want to remove and select Join the Clip. The benefit to use this technique compared to the previous one is the fact that you have more control directly inside the timelines. You can add or remove splits at any time, and you can add transitions between all the clips, as they are not individual clips anymore. And of course, you can color grade and add effects and titles. So if you are using a lot the Detect Cuts tool, switching to the studio version could be the right move to win a lot of time. As we have moved to the edit page, the next lesson will be on the fundamentals of the editing inside the edit page. So see you there, ciao ciao, bye bye.